This natural, homeopathic cream contains the most potent ingredients to soothe even the most excruciating pain associated with sciatica. Stop the pain now. Ask for Dr. Zhang's Sciatica Nerve Cream at your local health food store or go online to TraskNutrition.com.
Would you like relief from muscle pain, headaches, and discomfort to sleep better, have more energy during the day, and just feel naturally amazing? Fibromalic can help. Its blend of malic acid and magnesium can provide pain relief and comfort for those who experience fibromyalgia. It helps your body absorb more oxygen, and it works quickly for a significant reduction in pain within 48 hours, all without a prescription. Ask for Fibromalic at health and vitamin shops or shop Fibromalic.com.
Do you have $10,000 or more in outstanding federal student loans? You may qualify to have your entire student loan forgiven with one free call. That's right. If you're a teacher, police officer, firefighter, or work for a nonprofit, you may qualify for new federal programs to have your entire student loan forgiven. Graduate Service Center wants to give you free information on all the programs that can help. The sooner you call, the faster you can get relief. Get the maximum loan forgiveness, loan reduction, or consolidation available. Plus, find out in the first free call what you qualify for. A loan forgiveness specialist is standing by to answer all of your questions for free. Stop worrying about student loan payments. If you have $10,000 or more in federal student loans, this information could change your life. Call 800-315-9956. 800-315-9956. Wipe out your federal student loan debt. Find out how. Call 800-315-9956. 800-315-9956.
When we set out to build the largest and most technologically advanced tractor in Kubota history, we had your operation in mind. That's why we focused on the hard-working details, like powerful Kubota diesel engines, smooth shifting transmission options, a heavy-duty front axle, premium cab with the latest features, and a best-in-class Kubota front loader. Introducing the all-new M7 series, built with you in mind. We are Kubota. This is what we do.
This is KCAA.
I've been down so long it look like up to me. They look up to me. I got fake people showing fake love to me. Straight up to my face. Straight up to my face. I've been down so long it look like up to me. They look up to me. I got fake people showing fake love to me. Straight up to my face.
All right, here we go again. So it looks like today we're going to have a fantastic show for you here at KCAA Radio, 1050 AM, 102.3 FM, and the all-new 106.5 FM. So today we're going to talk a little bit about chemtrails. We're going to talk about Tom Brady, who's got his jersey, who doesn't. And I think we're going to talk a little bit about whatever pops in my head. So enjoy the ride. Talk to you soon.
Time they wanna take my place. I can tell that love is fake. I don't trust the words you say. How you wanna click up after your mistakes? Look you in the face and it's just not the same.
Alright, so here we go. So we're gonna get on into this here. You know, my name is Jason McDermott. You're here with me every Wednesday from 7 to 8 p.m. in beautiful Southern California. I also have Miss Pauline with me.
Hello.
Say hello one more time, beautiful.
Hello.
Alright. So I want to read a little something that a friend of mine. He gave me he's a writer and stuff. And I think he's writing for some manual or some scripting book or something. You know, I don't know whatever that is, but it's a way of how to live your life, I guess. Okay, and he wrote me something and actually read me something. And I thought it was very good, so I'm going to repeat it here with you guys. Is that okay?
Of course.
Pauline, that's all right.
Yeah.
Hey, if anybody can log into the webcast, we're at ustream.tv/channel/KCAATV. You got to see what this girl's wearing here today. All right, you know, I mean, I know we're on the radio, but gotta love my job. Huh. All right. So don't forget, it's ustream.tv/channel/KCAATV. All right, you can also reach us at 888-909-1050, or if you're local, at 909-888-5222. Don't forget, we're KCAA. We're on 1050 AM, 106.5 FM, and the all-new 102.3 FM. All right, so this thing is entitled here. It says, what we're looking for in an employee. The most important characteristic in working for me, or anyone else for that matter, is dependability. If you say you're going to make it at a particular time, well then, sonny boy, that is when you're promising butt better be there. You're not the only person attending, depending, or even monitoring that meeting. In today's markets, there's extreme wealth being generated on golf courses, at restaurants, even at these simple coffee shops. So if a potential client or even a potential acquaintance takes their time away from their family or busy personal existence seeking a possibility that you can somewhat help to restore their calm, well, that's why we do this, okay? That's why we talk to people, and that's why we sell. It's not just the money, but rather the encompassing feeling of power, that whenever you need help, come to me, and I will make sure no one does this to you, like, ever again. And there's a personal monetary gain coming directly from that person. Well, Mr. and Mrs. Professional, you better darn sure be at that location when you said you would and where you would. Collect the money. Take pride in who you are representing. Not only are you representing me, but most importantly, you're allowing another person the opportunity to witness you, your work ethic, your integrity, or even sometimes their lack of. Nobody's perfect, but we should never stop inspiring to become that perfect, motivational, selfless human being. Answer me how, or better yet, why. That prospect should ever believe a commitment, you know, completion date, expected return, how or when the best times are to reach you, that you promise them when you're not even on time for that first, most important loyalty-building meeting. They won't. Your window is closed and won't be open again anytime soon. So most important point to take from all of this is never get lazy, never cheat yourself, and most important, never, and I mean never, disrespect yourself. Now, tell you what, Michael McDermott, that was a very good thing you wrote there. What did you think about that?
I think it's really good.
That's a pretty good
way
to be.
Motivating.
Yeah, motivating, invigorating. You know, maybe knocks a couple people to look in the mirror a little bit. You know, and say, does that apply to me? How can I make it better for myself? You know, because really, all we are is a representation of who we are.
Yeah.
You know, even when we're working, doing whatever it is, even if we're doing something for nothing, you know?
Oh, I know.
We're a representation of who we are at all times. Okay, so do you want that one person who just met you today to think that you're this certain way? When in reality, all your life you've been a different way? No. Okay, you want to take pride in everything you do at all times. So that way they know who you are. Because that's who you are. Okay? So once again, want some callers to call in? It's going to be 888-909-1050. And in the local area?
909-888-5222.
Yeah, and don't forget to Ustream us. Okay? Ustream.tv. All right, it's going to be life camera action. Because as you all know, and if you've been around me, you know, the cameras are usually always rolling, you know, either by me or somebody else. But somebody's watching it at all times. So let's get into a little bit of chemtrail stuff.
All right.
Yeah, I know this is things we're not supposed to talk about, which I can just tell you what's in my head. I don't really know too much about any of it. But it seems to me that there's been a lot more things going on these days.
Yeah, it's actually been going on for a while, I heard.
Yeah, I mean, all I remember is that when I was a kid, all right, we used to look up in the sky and people's names would be drawn in there like, oh, Jason or Pauline or, you know, or Jason loves Pauline or something like that. Something crazy like that. You know what I mean? So, but nowadays it's like, I don't even see any words.
Words? Because they used to make it look, you know.
Pretty.
Like, yeah, there's nothing going on or it wasn't a bad thing.
I mean, it seems to me, last time I checked, I saw them right in front of my hotel, right? And I thought they were playing tic-tac-toe in there. there was a big X right where my hotel was. And the coolest thing was ever is this. They start off real light, right? And then they start getting real hardened. Like you can actually like walk on them. That's what I mean. I wish I could go walk on them. I think maybe that's what they do.
Maybe. I mean, it's, you know, we laugh about it, but it's not really that funny because it's like they're poisoning humanity, you know?
Well, do you think they're poisoning humanity? Because let's not forget, they're living in the same humanity as us.
Yeah, but they want to minimize population, so... I mean, how else are they going to do that without, you know, destroying their income? You can't just have a nuclear bomb go off and destroy everybody on this planet because then they're going to be poor, you know, and they'd have nobody to control or.
Gotcha. So the masses will basically just go crazy and run wild and.
Well, they technically just make people sick, you know, therefore they have to go to the doctors and the doctors then, you know, prescribe them.
Pills.
To the pharmacy, and then
you know, the money runs
it's
out.
Like, you know, a never-ending cycle.
Yeah, so basically it's all about giving the money and then how to take it all back, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. So you want to hear what my idea is?
Of course.
Yeah, I'm way out there, you guys, okay? So
yep,
listen, anybody that knows me knows I'm a little bit, you know, off my rocker, let's say. But no, I'm just kidding. So here's some things that we're probably not supposed to talk about, or we have been taught not to talk about in our life, because we've either been told, hey, you're crazy, you're nuts, you're this or that, or maybe you're on drugs, or maybe you're just cuckoo, right? But I want to let you guys all know this, okay? Yes, I've tried every single thing there is known to mankind, okay? I'm still here, and I'm still ticking. My memory is fantastic. It's actually getting better almost every day. I never get sick. Let's see. I'm in better shape than most people I know. I can outwork most people I know. I'm not that dumb of a guy. Okay, so all these brain cells that supposed to have been dead, they've come back to life. So, now one thing is, though, I might be seeing a few things different than some other people. All right, or maybe I'm just willing to talk about that now. So what I think is this. I think these chemtrails, what they are, is there's two different things. I think one is I think they put them up there to mask what's really going on behind the scenes. All right, when I say mask, I think that society isn't ready for what reality is. Okay? You got to realize, why are these animals so afraid every time they see us, they run away? Is it because we abused them, or we hurt them, or we scared them? Come on. People are not animals, things, beings, they're not supposed to run away as soon as they see another person. If you get trapped on some sort of planet somewhere, and you happen to see another life form, aren't you going to run to it and say, hey, how you doing?
You think?
I mean, I would.
Yeah.
I wouldn't see something else and go, oh, my gosh, they're going to kill me. I'm running. But that's what we've done, okay? That's what we've done to our animals. That's what we've done to our other beings. You know, because let's not forget, we aren't the only ones here. Okay, when I mean not the only ones here, there's life form in other places. I mean, don't forget the grass grows.
It does.
The trees grow. All right, there's other things that maneuver around a little bit. I mean, there's anything from the smallest thing you can't even see to sometimes the biggest things you can't even see. Or maybe you're not afraid, or maybe you're just not looking right. You know, we constantly think that everything's supposed to look just like us, but it doesn't. I mean, if it does, we'd be in heaven, wouldn't we?
Really?
Yeah. So, another thing I think we're a little afraid of is this. If we happen to stumble across something, and it just happens to be a lot bigger than we are, I mean, how can we be the best? Aren't we in a society where we have to be the best at everything? There's no points for second place, remember?
Unfortunately, I think we should all just work together, and all be in first place. But instead, somebody has to be better than the other person. It just makes them feel better. It's not right.
Exactly. And why do we have so much division? Why does everybody divide so much? Is that I have to be the best at everything again? Okay, my opinion of the best is not I've got this, I've got that, you don't. Okay, my idea of the best is I can get all these people to rally together for the good cause of everybody else. Okay, if I can teach somebody else to look after somebody else as opposed to just look after themselves, that's the best. Okay, the best is when you teach somebody how to be selfless and to think about their fellow person as opposed to just themselves.
Yep.
Yep. So back to chemtrails. Okay. I personally don't think that they're there to. Obviously, we know they're not there for just agriculture because they spray them everywhere. I mean, they spray them over the desert too.
They spray them.
And we know it's not from the afterburners from the planes. I mean, that was a nice theory too. And it's nice because you hit the thermal belt. Everything's supposed to kind of, stay stable there. Which that also doesn't make too much sense because I figure the closer you get to the sun, it's supposed to be warm, right? It's supposed to get hotter the closer you get to the sun.
I believe so.
Yeah, but yet you go hiking and you hit a certain level and then it starts getting colder. Look at Palm Springs.
They do say, heat rises.
Well, heat's supposed to rise, correct. Especially if you're closer to the sun. So what I'm thinking is this, okay, you got the thermal belt where it's like Palm Springs, okay? It's going to be 100 and something degrees outside. But you go up to that hill with that tram, and you'd have snow up there. I think it's Idlewild. That's what it's called, Idlewild, yeah. So you have snow there. So that kind of defeats that whole statement they were saying, because it seems like the further away you get, from this, I just don't understand it.
What, the chemtrails?
No, not the chemtrails. Chemtrails I get because, either they're trying to mask something, trying to shield something, trying to make it pretty, trying to maybe, make it sunny outside. What's that?
Chemical intoxication.
Chemical intoxication. Chemtrails. Chemical trails, yes. That's true. Do you think that's what we did to Venus?
Or Uranus.
my Uranus doesn't have too many chemtrails. That's good. There are no trails out of that one. Just some underwear. But you think that's what we did to Venus? Do you know how they say Venus is just clouds, period?
Mm-hmm.
You can't even live there because it's like a gas, it's like a greenhouse
effect.
The moon
is made of cheese.
Is it?
I don't know, but I love cheese.
Yeah. I don't think the moon's made of cheese, though. You know,
why not?
Because cause I think it would melt. I think the
moon's
just a big
spotlight. Do you
believe
somebody actually landed on the moon?
Well, I don't think we're going to get into that.
That's just a question. It could be yes or no.
Do I believe somebody landed on the moon?
Yeah.
I personally, if you want to know my opinion about all this.
I do.
I think the moon's just a big light.
Oh, yeah, you told me.
Yeah, remember that? I think that what it is we're basically an experiment out here, you guys.
Oh, no, we are.
You know, yeah, and people are watching us to see how we react to certain
things.
The
government's experience.
Well, the government is us.
Yeah. Okay, but.
I mean, we all like to think that, oh, the government. Listen, if we don't want the government, we just stop being part of the government.
Well, it's kind of hard when you live in a world controlled by the government. Therefore, you have no choice but to follow their rules.
Bow down and do what they tell you, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. So I'm like your government.
Not in a good way.
So I'm like your government. You can be my government sometimes.
Okay.
Yeah, see that? See, you got to give and take, you guys. Give and take. So, here's the thing. A lot of people talk about the government this, government that, government that. I'll tell you what. Why don't you send me some information, okay? You can send it to Life, LIFE, Camera, CAMERA, Action, ACTION, 123, @gmail.com. And go ahead and tell me what you think about this, okay? Because tell you what, the government, we are the government. It's for the people, by the people, I believe, correct?
No, I don't believe that.
Well, then that's
the way it was supposed to be.
That's the way it was supposed to be.
Well, I mean, yeah, they are people, but they obviously seem to be people that don't care too much about other people.
Well, the people that we put in their place, okay, we're the ones that put them there because they're supposed to be our voice. All right, now what happens is that they start getting a little greedy and the power starts to get to them. Okay, they start believing all the hype that surrounds it, like, oh, you're the greatest. You're this. Oh, fly me here. Fly me there. Let me take you here. Let me take you there. You want this? You want that? Whatever you need, I got you. Okay? Because the people that are doing that are trying to get that. Everybody wants a famous friend. Okay? Everybody wants somebody that's been in the movies or somebody that's done this or, you know, it's just that guy, you know, or that girl. You know, somebody always wants that person because that's what makes them feel like they're in the front seat. Okay? So.
What if you like the back seat?
Well, the back seats, you know, sometimes there's time for a back seat then. You can go sit in the back.
I will.
No, okay. Just keep it warm. I'll be back there later. So we get done with the front seat. And what was I doing? Where was I going? Throw me off. No, she didn't throw me off. Here's what happens, okay? So all these different people in power, people with money, they want to have a friend that's in politics, okay? Because then that way they feel that they have some sort of angle or somebody they can talk to and try and get their point across. Now what happens is this. If we negate that, all right, and we as a people get tired of the things that are going on, well, listen, you have a friend in me, okay? I can get out there to put, 5 million people I can reach, okay? With that, I'm sure out of those 5 million, I could probably get a hold of some celebrities. They could reach a heck of a lot more. I mean, how many movies do how much? A heck of a lot of money. A lot of people go see movies. So
how
if we now, so if we get the point across there of what we think should be better, and I'm not just talking about, oh, we should make work weeks 3 days a week instead of 5 days a week. I mean, nothing like that, okay? Let's just talk about some serious stuff, all right? And also you all know what I'm talking about, okay? With things that are not fair. Like, hey, companies that make shoes that cost 50 cents to make, but the people making the shoes don't have shoes. Where does that happen? Okay, that's stuff that needs to be fixed, okay? But no one's going to know about fixing that until somebody speaks up and lets somebody know that can get out there to people. Okay, you got to realize that everyone talks about, you know, Trump this, Trump that, Trump that. He sounds like a great guy, okay, sometimes, and sometimes he doesn't. But for the most part, we back him up because we're Americans and we have to. He's running our company. Okay, he's running our company. All right, now here's the major point. He's what you call a spokesman, okay? And what they do is this is what celebrities do. Celebrities read the agenda to the public, okay? What they do is if people want to agree with the celebrities, okay? They want to adapt them. They put them on a pedestal. So they believe their words are basically sacred, and oh my gosh, they're the word of God sometimes, okay? And that's just people that can communicate with other people, all right? So that's kind of, that's what we do here. So here at the headquarters. So basically what I'm saying is that the best thing to do is if you feel that you're being wronged in this government, okay, it can be fixed. All right, and how you go about fixing it is not complaining to your neighbor, not going to the corner store and talking to this or that or the barber shop, even though I haven't been there in a while. but is to talk to somebody that can actually do something about it. Okay, that's not going to agree with everything you say, because sometimes we're wrong. Sometimes we get, even me, I'm wrong a lot. Okay, so we get, you know, we start getting on our little high horse. We start thinking we know it all, especially, I think I know everything. No, but at least just a little bit about everything. I do.
Yeah, you do.
Yeah, I do know it, though. It's not. Check the J store. So, good job, Davey. So, back to what we're talking about. So, chemtrails, I think that either a way to mask things. I think that if you take a big, bright light, okay, put it against your body. You take a picture against yourself. Well, you're not going to see anything with that bright light.
A picture against yourself.
Well, of yourself. You know, let's say you take like what we do at what we do at home, baby.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so.
Yeah, I know.
So we get the lights, the bright lights, you know. And then we put them on certain body parts, okay? and then the other person starts taking pictures of that light against your body. Now, there's a big hole there. All you see is white. Yeah. That's it. Nothing else. So if me as a ding-dong can figure that out, okay, don't you think they could make chemicals and everything else that makes things just invisible so you can't see it just like that?
I don't know. I mean, I think nowadays anything's possible. But just by what I read, you know, it makes sense. Like, as far as, you know, how far back the government's actually, like, started doing this. I had notes on it, but it's going to take a minute.
Find those notes. Well, you know, did you know that we have a space treaty, too, I heard?
No, I don't believe
so. A lunar space treaty to where you're not allowed, I guess a bunch of countries, and I don't even know if this is true. This is alleged, okay? So, you know, we hear a lot of stuff, and you know what else the scary part is, before I get into this, is that how do we know if the stuff on the internet's even real?
Yeah, true.
Yeah, I mean, you try and believe in all these, some of these websites and everything, but then you go down all the way to the bottom, it says when it was last updated. So who the heck are these people? I mean, I don't know who Ding Dong Bot and Bing Bomb and you know, E at the Americana is. I don't know who these people are, but you know what they do? They do.
Mm-hmm.
Because they mess things up. Okay, they start putting things on there that's not real. They start taking family members away from you that were never there. Or were there.
Yeah.
They start dictating how your life's supposed to go, and that's not a very good thing. You know, I mean, I think the this computer generation is just killing me. I mean, I become, supposedly I'm not even alive.
That's not mine.
Isn't that hilarious? Yeah, I looked at my credit reports, you know, because you get those free score things or, you know, this or that. You know, my whatever website it is, you can check out your credit scores. So, you know, I'm getting back on track. I'm thinking about maybe, you know, getting another house or doing something like that. And you know, FHA, you do have a very good program out there. So anybody looking to purchase homes, I can definitely steer you in the right direction of some good lenders. But back to what I'm saying is I looked up my credit scores, and, you know, two were like in 700-somethings. I mean, that's pretty good. I thought that was good. And another one had no score. And, of course, it's the most important one there is, right? What is it, Experian?
Yeah.
So that had no score on it at all. And I said, wait a minute. Why is that? So I scrolled down and says, it looks like I've been reporting as deceased. Did I miss something?
Your funeral?
Yeah, did I miss something? I mean, can somebody please tell me what happened? If you were at my funeral, please call in, okay? The phone number is 909-888-5222. And what's the toll-free number?
888-909-1050.
Okay, you can also reach us on the Ustream. And that's ustream.tv/channel.kcaatv. Or it's kcaaradio.com. Okay, that'll be for the replay now. I guess probably by later today or tomorrow. So, I guess I'm deceased. I look pretty good for a dead person, huh?
I'd say so.
Yeah, maybe that's why my memory's back so strong.
Your body feels pretty warm.
Body feels good and warm. And then my neck's still growing, huh?
Yeah.
Is it thick today or not so much?
It's pretty thick. Sweaty.
It's sweaty. It is warm out here, huh? Yeah. It's hot. It's hot when you're in the oven. So, chemtrails, I think what they're doing is they're trying to hide stuff. Not hide stuff, but trying to prevent the public from freaking out.
You know,
I see a lot of different things out there. And that kind of goes back to that. Remember I was telling you about that dude that I met last week? That bromance thing I was talking about?
Yes.
So check this out. So I call him up. I'm like, hey, bro, what's going on? And he's like, oh, nothing. I got this party I'm going to. I said, oh, you do? Cool. He says, yeah, if you want to come with me, I mean, you're more than welcome to come. I said, all right, yeah. So we go out to these hills. I'm not going to tell you guys what hills, but, you know, they're hills. And so, and so we go out to this place. And we're drinking, having a good time. And, you know, then all these different, like, LED lights. There's some weird lighting starts coming on, you know? And I've been noticing a lot of these different kinds of lights everywhere, and that's pretty interesting. Kind of like it, but
you have.
Yeah, basically see a lot of cool stuff. Yeah, maybe it's that psychological, counseling stuff, I guess. God bless them. Yeah. They really want to dip in my head that much. Okay, let's go.
Really?
Hang on for the ride. So I'm looking around, and I start seeing, like, I don't know if you guys remember this. Remember that movie, The Predator?
Yes.
Okay, remember when you can't see him? He's like invisible mode.
Yeah.
It was just like, it looks like a differentiated color, but
it's all blurry.
Yeah, it's all blurry, like a big energy ball or something. Or when you look at a fire, if you look above the fire or it's real hot, the asphalt, and you start seeing, it starts looking all wavy, the air.
Yes.
Well, I'll tell you what, that's what I was seeing. Okay? And it was real wavy, and it was like in the trees and different trees. And I'm just like, whoa, wait a minute. So I'm starting to think maybe I had too much to drink or something because, you know, hey, I've been known to do that. Maybe it might have been all the, we're not going to talk about that, but all my previous, abuses.
Abuses.
But, you know, so I started talking to my friend. I said, hey, you see that over there? He goes, what do you mean? So I started pointing it out to him. He's like, well, yes, I do. And he said that as if he, this was like a normal thing for him.
That's a first, huh?
Yeah, it was actually a first, because usually I'm the one that thinks it in my own head, and everyone tells me I'm nuts. But they only tell me I'm nuts when there's other people around. So when there's nobody around, then we have conversations like as if they know exactly what I'm talking about, Patrick. So that's what seems to be happening, okay? So here was actually, I was very impressed because somebody actually said that they saw what I was seeing and knew about it, as if they were adamant. That means very certain.
Really?
Yes, it does.
Wow.
Yeah, you like it like that? Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm getting pretty smart.
Yes, you are. So, where are you guys going from here? I mean, so you guys are seeing some predators.
Well, I would say predators, no. The predators are bad.
Some.
I didn't see any people with guns or stuff like that.
Some good.
It felt really good energy, okay? To me, here's the thing. To me, it felt like a really good energy, a very good calm. I don't know if maybe that was his relatives, family, or the people's party we were at. But the area was really nice. I mean, it was really good feeling about it. Okay, as if something stronger than me was actually looking at me, you know, and admiring, you know, the work that I've been doing. It felt really good. And I don't know if, I know people always get scared of, oh, is it a ghost? Ghosts are bad, this and that. I mean, I've never personally seen a ghost that I can recall. I mean, I've just seen things I can't explain. But they've never been mean to me. I mean, I've never gotten a feeling of scared, or I've never gotten a feeling of, oh, my God, I better run. Oh, my God, the green men are coming. You know, the only time I've gotten those feelings is when the police are coming to get me.
Oh, my goodness.
Yes. So these beings or whatever it was, okay, and I did a little research, and they do have a study about energy beings if you guys want to look that up. Mm-hmm. I don't know if that's available to the public, but hey, it might be now. Okay.
Or so, not.
Or not. But I would definitely go check that out if it is, because these things were unbelievable. And it wasn't that I got to see any person or people or anything like that, so I'm not trying to say that this or that or the other thing, but whatever I was feeling that day really felt good. It felt pure.
Where was I?
You were, I don't know. Where were you? I think you were just getting that thing more beautified than it is.
Really?
Yeah, I don't know. Whoever was with my girl that day, you know, hey, better keep a good eye on her. Yeah, so back to what I'm talking about. All right. I tell you what, I think we all need to just change our opinion about things. All right, I don't believe that aliens are out there trying to come and get us. They're just waiting for us to get fat so they can come and eat us. All right, or, you know, what else is the major conspiracies that they're going to take us and probe us and stick things in us and do all kinds of weird stuff?
Chips in us.
Chips, well, I think we do that, don't we?
Like potato chips? I eat a lot of hot Cheetos.
Potato chips, yeah, especially potatoes. Potato skins.
Potato skin. Those are yummy. Potato skins.
Need some potato skins tonight, I think.
Yeah.
Yeah. For some reason, she nicknamed me Potato Skin. I don't know what that means.
It's cute.
I used to like to eat potato skins.
I do.
God bless her.
It's because you have freckles.
Oh, I do have freckles. I did.
And
you're
white.
Yeah, some white, and then, you know, sometimes my skin gets a little. See, I'm Irish, so what
so
happens
it's
is
like the skin of the potato, you know.
Yes, especially when I have a tan.
It's a compliment.
Oh, it is. Oh, potato skin
I
is
like
a compliment.
Potato skin. You call me lamb chop. What? Slim?
Yeah. What? Isn't that good? You don't have
shady,
color bunches, though.
Slim shady.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Cream puff.
Puffy cream.
Puffy creams. Yeah. Okay, so before we get sidetracked here. So we're going to try and change people's opinion about things, all right? Things that don't look like us, we don't need to be afraid of them, okay? I mean, you all know what you're capable of. If you don't, then you need to go to some sort of, physical training thing. You know what I mean? I used to box when I was a kid. You know, before that, I didn't know what I was about. I used to get into arguments, fights over stupid stuff, you know, just because I wasn't secure with myself, I guess. You know, once you start learning how to defend yourself and take care of yourself, you're going to realize that you don't have to be so tough guy all the time or tough girl, all right? You got to realize that, yeah, obviously you want to make sure that nobody takes advantage of you, and you want to pay attention because they will get ugly real fast, okay? People will definitely be nice to you 1 minute until they find that one little hole, and they're going to try and jump on it, all right? So definitely be careful. Keep yourself guarded, but it's okay to let your guard down sometimes. I've just come to learn to realize that.
Yeah.
Yeah, she made me drop my guards a little bit, everybody.
Yay.
Yeah. So that's good. I'm actually feeling pretty good about that.
Good, me too.
Yeah. So remember, if something doesn't look like you, don't be afraid of it. Don't go try and kill it right away. You know, I mean, maybe the animals will actually come up to us from now on, you know, instead of run away as soon as they hear us or see us. You know, they shouldn't be like that.
It's because we're eating them all.
Let me think about it. Deer comes out. I mean,
we're eating.
Yeah, well, but we're not only eating them all. I mean, sometimes they have these tournaments where they go shoot deers and stuff, which is okay.
What?
But, I mean, how do you expect a deer to come say hi to you when his buddies and his brothers and sisters got blown away?
Yeah.
They're not. All right, they're going to tell their brothers and sisters, and for generations, they're going to be scared of you. That's not good.
Like, aren't we lucky that they can't shoot guns? Like a deer coming at you.
Yeah, imagine if they got to hunt us. They'd be like, well, I got you now. I'm waiting for this day. You know, I mean, come on. Or, I mean, even me. It's like I was at fire camp, and I was cutting all these trees down and stuff. I didn't even know about any of that stuff. I was just doing what I was told. You know, and now you got, how do I know these trees aren't mad at me? They're like, there he is. Let's go get him.
Really? You know? The one outside your room.
I got two of them outside my room. They're really cute. I like them. I'll show some pictures of them this time. They really like taking pictures, too. They get all warm and fluffy. Too bad their leaves. Too bad their leaves are fiber optic. Thanks, guys. Yeah. You watch anything good at nighttime? Speaking about drones. Remember we talked about drones the other last week?
Yes.
What do you guys know about this? So I'm laying on bed, and you know, of course, I got Cutie Pie over here laying on top of me. So I'm laying on this bed. I look up, and guess what? I like to leave my window, my curtains open. I mean, you know, if I'm in the house sometimes, I don't want it to be pitch dark. Okay. So it's like on a 2-3 in the afternoon, and all of a sudden, I'm on the 6th floor, keep in mind, of a 7th floor building. All of a sudden, this little remote control helicopter decides to pop its head right up where my right up where my sliding door is. I'm like, what's going on here? Once again, guys, listen. Okay, if you want to see so bad what's going on in there, just buy some tickets.
Really?
All right, yeah.
You have nowhere to purchase them.
Well, you know what? We can change that right now. Here's what you do. If you'd like to purchase tickets, or a subscription or a membership, and we'll put bleachers in there so you can get certain seating. See, better seating is available than others. Okay, you can get it at
VIP.
VIP is right. Well, I don't know about that. That's going to be pretty expensive.
Well,
hey. Anyway, everything's negotiable, okay? So you can get those at life, LIFE, camera, action, 123@gmail.com. Okay, put your request in. We'll get those taken care of. But this way you don't have to do it sneaky like, okay? Because I'm not shy.
It's not really too sneaky, though.
I mean, they're trying to be sneaky, though.
I know, like, yeah. Most definitely.
I was like, why do you want to do that? You know, so we're going to see who's flying the helicopter. I mean, the one flying the helicopter is the one with the remote control in their hand.
Yeah.
Duh. Or that's actually just the one that's going to get beat up for it, you know? And everyone else is pretty smart. They say, hey, here's a $20. You go ahead and ride on that thing, would you?
Yeah.
$20. So, anyway. Hey, what's going on with the... Energy beings, please come back to me. Speaking of the bromance, that went really well. We got to hang out there for a minute. Showed me a lot of different things
So, I mean, we're
going from there?
Are you guys, what is this, like,
I don't know. I mean, he might think I'm just an idiot.
You guys can't hang out, maybe.
I'm not hanging out, no doubt about it, but I think he might not want to hang out with me because he might think I'm just, like, smart enough to hang out with him.
Kind of jealous.
Well, you should be. You should tell me. If those energy things are real, I'm going to have a good old time.
Great.
Yeah, I'm going to the invisible world.
That's cool. You better forget at least invite me.
Transparency. Oh yeah, you're coming along. Don't worry.
Good.
Yeah. Yum. That'd be great if there really was something like that. Let's say he took me out in the clouds sometime or something. What if they really had something like that? I wouldn't mind taking you on a cloud and just doing some really fun things up there.
Yeah, me too.
Or looking over and everybody, I said, you call your mom or something. Hey, we're going to be flying over your pad.
Hmm. We're on a cloud above you.
Hey, we're on a cloud. Just look at us. See? Oh, there we are, poking our head out. We'll drop a ladder down. Come on up.
Imagine.
That'd be great.
Yeah. Minus the chemtrails.
Yeah, well, I think that's how we get to the clouds. Think about it, because the chemtrails, they shoot them out there. Like Spider-Man. Okay? And then when they harden
doesn't
up.
Doesn't really look that cool.
But when they harden up, I know they can't walk on those. Hmm.
Mm.
Or maybe that's where they mark their territory. Like, here's the X right here. That's where we're going to land.
I mean, maybe real clouds, you know, but not these fake chemical-made, man-made thingies.
Or the white clouds and the brown clouds.
It's just some weird stuff going on up there.
Oh, it is cool. I remember when I was a kid, they told me that clouds are just, you know, that's where the moisture gets sapped in. And then when I went to fire camp, they told me, oh, clouds, that's where the temperature level stops. That's where all the moisture gets cumulative clouds or something like that. Whatever. That's where all the moisture gets too cold or too warm, and it just, like, stops right there. But now it comes to find out this is a whole bunch of other different stuff.
Yeah.
Now, did they know the truth, or were they just BSing me?
Well, I don't know.
Or were they just as ignorant as me?
All the above?
All the above, yes. You know, I thought I was the only stupid one out there, but I guess not. So, I tell you, one of these days we'll get to walk on the clouds. That'd be great, wouldn't it? They always tell us, don't be a dreamer. Why not?
Yeah, dream on.
Everyone deserves to dream. Remember
dream
that.
On.
Dream for the year. See, they had it right back then, didn't they?
Yeah.
That's amazing. A lot
all
of LSD.
All this music, subliminal messages. People just have to pay attention and open their eyes.
Pay attention. Remember these movies you see? They got them from somewhere. Somebody's living that life.
Us.
Duh. I think they got another one coming out. I think they're doing some sort of, I'm not even going to talk about that. You'll see it when it comes out. You know, but, yeah, you got to figure these rap songs, these, you know, every song in general, not just rap songs. I don't mean to pick one genre, okay? But that's just what's mostly in my ears. And these movies, somebody lives those lives, okay? Sometimes it's imagination, yeah, sure, but imagination comes from somewhere, okay? And that's what gives people the motivation or the desire to go see these things, because they can relate to them, because they've all probably been through them at one point in time also, or yeah. They're going to. So that's what's going to happen. And you pay attention, like she said, pay attention to what you see. Pay attention to people around you. You know, if you see somebody having a hard time, I mean, you know, help them. You know, I'm not talking about everybody, because, I mean, we ran into this one person last week. And usually we help, if we see somebody having a hard time, like a homeless person or something like that needs a little bit of help or just a hand up or something, I'm going to help them if I can. And so is she.
Yep.
All right. Whether it be we're going to get some food for them, we're going to get them a blanket, we're going to get something for them. You know, that we think can help them. If they look like they need a drink, I might even get them one of those. But, you know, since I've been there, I know it. You know, listen, I know how it is. And, you know, one day is not going to change something, but that might just help them get through that night. Okay? So, but when I see somebody that's standing on the side of a freeway with a little sign saying, help me, I got 3 kids or 10 families or whatever it might be, and then coming up and, you know, asking me, just showing the thing, the sign, and I'm like, hey, I know somebody that might be able to get you a job. Do you need a job? And then they act as if they can't understand me, okay? And so I speak in their language. They still can't understand me because, you know, I am affluent, you know. So, I mean, I'm multi-talented. They still can't understand me. So then I say, job, job, job. No, 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 no understand, no understand. Okay, I got it. Then the funny thing is the next day I'm at the, you know, drive-through car wash, and who do I see pull up in a new Mercedes? That same person on the side of the freeway that said she was struggling with the 3 kids and couldn't pay for anything and please help and didn't understand English.
All I wanted was a new Mercedes.
That's all I wanted, but I went out and got it.
Lord knows.
Okay, so thing is this. I mean, come on. If you have the ability to work and you are working, don't use people's generosity as a paycheck.
Not only that, don't use your kids. That's so wrong. I've seen so many women out there, you know, stating that not only themselves but their children are, you know, homeless and starving, you know, like from hunger. And I don't know, it's crazy. It's sad.
There's always something you can do if you go out to get it, all right? If you can't think of a good idea, contact me, 888-909-1050 or 909-888-5222, KCAA Radio. You're at 106.5, 102.3, and 10:50 a.m. Contact me. I'll figure out a way to help you get it.
Only for that, though.
Only for that, yeah. We don't need anything else. I'm good with that other part.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's going to a nice little warm spot here. But if you do need help getting back on track, you need help finding a job. I mean, come on, let's see. I got 11 felonies.
What?
11. All right. No, if I sat around and said, "Oh, what am I going to do? No one's going to hire me." That would, you know, the first time I got one, it would have been over at that point, right?
So they say.
So they say. But I mean, just to give you a little background on me, I mean, I've done a lot of things. I've done collections. I've been a financial advisor, first vice president of a major firm, Morgan Stanley, and I've also done tax stuff and everything else like that. So, you know, I've done a lot of things, even though I was told I was never going to be able to do anything. You know, yeah, I'm at the same place. I got maybe about, you know, 50 cents in my pocket to rub together right now. But see, I know how to do a lot of things, you know, because I've never really listened to anybody. You know, I was always thought I could do it better than you can. Or I'm not going to ask you because you're not going to really tell me how to really do it because you're not going to want me to be better than you. So I've always tried to do it myself. And obviously doing that, I've lost a few times. You know, because I always usually have to learn things the hard way. And the hard way means losing it all. You know, it's either all or none. So that we've come to realize that it doesn't work. So now we're going to try middle road it this time. Okay. So anybody needs help, listen, I'm always here to listen. If it's a good idea, I can help you with a business plan. I can help you figure out how to get money. I can help you figure out how to just get back on track or, you know, put your negativity behind you. You know, because if we look in our mirror and say, "This nobody's going to hire me because of this or this or this," that's BS. All right, because they don't know about that, and that. All they know is what you portray. Just like that thing that my friend wrote, that employee thing, okay? If you say you're going to be somewhere at a certain time and you show up, you know, 30 minutes late, well, how does that look?
Not good.
Not good. Or if you show up into an interview and you're chewing gum, like you got a big mouthful of, gum. I don't know, whatever it is, yeah, a big mouthful of hay, how's that going to look?
Like, okay? A horse.
Yeah, you know, or if you go... Or if you show up as a nursing job and you show up in a miniskirt, I mean, come on now. You know, this is not going to work out, all right? And there's nobody to blame on that but ourselves, okay? Because we are portraying that image. We're actually knocking ourselves out before we even get in the fight. That's not good. Give yourself a fighting chance. You know, I mean, I tell you what, here's how bad I am. I used to train for boxing and stuff when I was younger, okay? So, you know, I'm getting ready to do the Golden Gloves. It's like 1990. Nine or something like that. It was a while back. I think you were, what, about seven?
99. I was seven.
She was seven. That was pretty good there. Seven, that's the G. That's a good job. So, 1997. Here's how bad I was. Or 1999. So, you know, I used to have a couple girlfriends around the town. And, you know, I used to go out a lot, drink a lot, party a lot, having good, you know, all my friends, everything like that. So, what I did, I stopped doing everything. I told all the people I was seeing, I can't see anymore. You know, I stayed home. I didn't go out anywhere. You know, I ran in the morning, worked out at night, sometimes ran at night, too, if I couldn't sleep. But it was just, you know, it was brutal on a lot of people because a lot of people like to, you know, I'm like the talkative guy. Okay, so we'll go out somewhere, and I'll be the one talking to all the girls. I'll be the one talking to all the people. I bring everybody to the party. All right, so when I went on a little break for myself because I wanted to make sure that I gave myself the best possible chance to win. Okay, I bet you I lost a lot of friends during that time. And they all try and give you that guilt trip, like, "Oh, man, you were so much more fun when you were drinking. Why can't you start drinking again?" You know, or, "Oh, man, we had so much fun. We were doing this and that with all these different people. But how come we can't do that again?" It's like, okay, so you want me to go ahead and stop what I am focused on doing, ruin, you know, mess myself up a little bit, not be able to see the next day and all this other good stuff, have to apologize to half the population because of it, all because you want to go beat some girls and stuff like that? Is that really real? So what I'm saying is give yourself the best possible chance to win, all right? Treat your body right. If you know you're going to be somewhere on Monday, maybe stay home on Sunday. You know what I mean? And that's what I did, okay? And they also told me that you can't have sex and stuff during, you know, right before a fight either. That was a real bad one because, you know, that's what I'm all about.
Calm down.
Yeah. So what I did is I actually stopped that too for 2 weeks before the fight.
Wow.
Hey, 2 weeks, you got to figure, that's 14 shots right there.
Wow.
That's 14 shots, sometimes 28.
That's horrible.
But like I said, the whole key to this thing is this. Forget about the sex, forget about the other stuff. It's about giving yourself the best possible chance to win. All right? So if, you know what it is, what you have to do. If you don't know what you have to do, call me, I'll help you. You know, every position is a little bit different. You know, every job, every career has a different situation. All right, so if you need help with it, I'll help you because you can get to anything. No, you're not going to be able to just go from A to finish right away. There's going to be steps you have to take along the way, and if you're destined or if you're basically focused and driven, then no one should be able to stop that. And what I would recommend, the most important thing is, write down what you want to do. Write down your goal. You know, tape it to your window. Tape it to your bathroom window.
Your forehead.
Well, you're not going to see your forehead every day.
Yeah, if you look in the mirror.
Well, yeah, some people don't look in the mirror. Yeah, true. What I would do is this. I would take a piece of paper, write down your goal, short-term goal, something attainable, but a little bit out of reach right now, and tape it to your bedroom wall.
Put it in your cell phone, since that's all everybody does nowadays.
Yeah. You could do that, too. I'd put it in a bunch of places. I'd put it on, like I said, the bathroom mirror. Tape it to that. I'm going to keep saying it until people get it through their head, because, you know, you keep talking about cell phones and this and that, and, you know, hey. I don't want you guys to be discouraged. Don't get drift off on me.
Discouraged.
Just don't drift off on me.
Then drift off.
Yes. So, bathroom mirror, tape it to it.
Got that.
Bedroom door, tape it to it. Back of the front door, tape it to it. Somewhere you're going to see it every single day a lot. Okay? You tape up what your goal is. Somewhere you're going to see it every day. You're eventually going to get there. You're going to have to. You have no choice. You see it every day until you get sick of seeing it. It's like, Jesus Christ. This thing go away. So what are you doing over there, drawing?
Picture of me and you.
A picture of me and you? It's like a little rose there. I don't know. That doesn't look like me and you now. So what we got going on this weekend? What do we got going on this weekend? Anything exciting?
My friend. Oh, actually, I wanted to give a shout out to my friend Marianne. Happy birthday, Marianne.
Happy birthday, Marianne.
Yeah, she invited us to go out with her. So.
All right, real good.
Might do that.
Yeah, she's a cute one.
Of course, see my amazing child.
Is Marianne single these days?
I love you.
Kind of not? Or
I don't know.
Technically, yes.
I don't know, honestly.
Well, if there's any single guys, then we might have a Marianne.
Huh?
Oh, looks like we got a caller, so hang on for just 1 second. Go ahead and hit that button over there. Caller, how can we help you?
Hello, is this Jason?
This is Jason. Who is this?
Jason, I wanted to find out and get some advice from you on how to get a start if you're in collections.
If you're in collections. Okay,
yeah.
Now in collections on in collections as a field, or if you're personally in collections?
And collections in the field. And what would you say if you wanted to hire some young person who was hungry and eager?
What I would do is if I had to hire somebody in collections that was hungry and eager, because that used to be me at one point, remember? I think you do believe that. What you do is you make sure that person keeps their ears open. All right? I had a great boss back then. I had a few great people I worked with in collections. So actually, you actually sound like somebody I used to know. So
you had somebody who had a good boss?
We had a couple good bosses, but we had a couple that were a little crazy too.
Really?
I believe like one that used to make us stand on our chair, stand up, take our chairs away, but I like that. You remember that one?
Yeah.
You remember that one.
I remember that one.
Yeah, I think you do. But what was his name? Richard what? Cough?
You remember who I am?
I sure do, Nadine. How you doing?
JJ.
Yeah, what's happening?
Good. I'm proud of you. You're really moving up in the world still.
Yeah, I'm
giving a lot
to
of good advice, huh?
Well, I'm trying. I mean, I've been through a lot. You know it, and I know it. You remember there?
Yep.
You were there when I was, what, 18 years old?
18.
Mm-hmm.
Got you nice and hungry, and you were ready to make some money, and you took the world by the reins, and look where you are now.
By
good
the
for
holidays.
You.
Yeah, so we're getting back on track. But we used to have fun back then, didn't we?
More fun than we should have.
Way more fun. One good thing about that is it taught me how to track people down, which is good.
Well, I can't give away my secrets on tracking people down. You know that.
No. I'm never going to give your secrets away anyway, so don't you worry about that. But I would say, now I want to get all personal with you now. You still have my phone number, right?
Yeah, actually, you have mine still.
I do? Is the same one?
Yep.
Okay. Yeah, we definitely got to get together. And how's everybody else? How's the family?
Everybody's great. Whole fam bam's perfect.
Sometimes.
Everything.
Hey, thanks for always being there for me, okay?
All right. I'm proud of you, okay?
Talk to you soon, my dear.
All right. Talk Bye-bye. To you. Bye.
So that was a good friend of mine. She's awesome. You know, she helped me at a time where, hey, I didn't have a job. I didn't have anything. I was, you know, living in an apartment. We were paying like $500 a month. It was, you know, roaches galore. You know, that's how it goes down, you know? And so we just came out from an abandoned house, me and the girl I was with. So we get this apartment, and I look in the newspaper, and it says, you know, wanted for collections. We'll train, no experience necessary. So I said, well, that sounds like me, no experience necessary, we'll train. So I go over there, and it's this nice building that I used to look at, and, you know, say, that'd be cool to work there. And they liked me, and you know, they just, I wanted to do anything. I started to believe in these people to where I was willing to open up and listen to everything they would tell me, you know, and I really wanted to implement it into my life, and it worked really well, you know, because they really did have my best interest at heart. And a lot of times people don't, but these people did, and they showed me how to do things, and, you know, when I have little bumps in the road, because I did, you know, they wouldn't turn their back on me. You know, when things got rough for me, that's when they actually stood up and said, here, we got you, don't worry, come here, this is what you should do. All right, and I'll never forget that, because that was something that I don't really see very often anymore. And more people need to be like that. You know, when you see people having a hard time, or when certain things just, because these aren't always going to go right for all of us all the time, all right? And if somebody is mentoring you like they did with me, and sometimes I fall and stumble, because I'm just human too. I mean, I'm gonna make mistakes sometimes. So when you fall and stumble, don't turn your back on them. You know, be like these people did for me. You know, and they went ahead and looked backwards and said, hey, it's okay. I know it's hard. All right. And I know you're going to get through this. And just dust yourself off. Call me tomorrow. All right. And that meant more to me than a lot of things. So real good job, Nadine. Thank you for calling in. You're awesome. I always had a great time with you. Your family's terrific. You know, everything's really good. So thanks for calling in. Appreciate that. Now, what are you doing there, dear? We got in the cup.
Juice.
Gin and juice?
No, I wish.
Oh, we need some gin. Can anybody bring some gin down here?
Really?
Actually, we only got 5 more minutes, so I guess that's going to be too short of a party for that. But sooner or later, we might have some live webcast from the house. That's always a good time. Yeah.
Indeed it is.
Yes, it is indeed. So remember, next week, I want you guys to, well, this week coming up, whenever you want, I want you to email me, call the station, call whatever. So give me some things you want to talk about. You know, because, I mean, I could talk about me all day. I love doing that. You know, I've got something good to look at here. And, you know, never run out of things to talk about, especially when it's about me.
Oh, my goodness.
I know my head's a little big for itself, but, you know, yeah, it's okay. I still fit through the door. Every once in a while.
Yeah.
So back to these, what were we talking about again? So what did we talk about today? We talked about some chemtrails.
Mm-hmm.
Hey, I also want to talk about the homeless situation.
Did you even talk about Tom Brady?
Oh, Tom Brady. Yeah. Who took his jersey? Because that's not very nice, you guys. Let's think of it like this. Imagine if you became known as the greatest quarterback ever. Okay, 5 Super Bowls. Okay, I don't know if you know what that means, but sometimes people can't get one, and they're great players. All right, this man has won. Actually, he's led his team because he's the quarterback, so he takes all the hits. Don't forget, if they do great, you know, he gets the praise. But when they do bad, even if it's not his fault, he's getting the hit hard. All right, he has to stay in there and say, hey, I did that. Okay, it's my fault. This is what we're going to do. All right, when everybody's wondering what to do and they're all tired and breathing heavy and throwing up on the, you know, they're going to look at him with these eyes like a little kid saying, please tell us what we should do. And he's going to tell them, he's going to lead them, and they're going to win. All right, so they got 5 of those. 5 championships. All right.
I'm sorry, now, how many?
5.
Wow.
Uno, dos, tres, cuatro, cinco. All right.
Oh, okay, I understood that.
Yes, well, you're Spanish. You should know that.
I'm Mexican.
Yeah, you know, hey, I'm a Rasa friend. Hey. There you go. I like you too.
I love you.
Aw. Is that direct to me?
Yeah. Aw,
I love you too, baby. So, yeah, now I'm getting all emotional and stuff, you know, hey. So back to Mr. Tom Brady. I like the Patriots. I think they're a great team. I think, you know, I think you could talk about every team there is, the, you know, this, that, or allegedly deflating the balls or this and that, whatever. Who knows what they're talking about? But every team does something. It has nothing to do with this guy. This guy gets paid to go play. You know, he leaves his wife and his kids, or whatever. I don't know how many kids he has, but he leaves his wife and kids in his nice house and everything else to come entertain you guys on the weekend. All right, and get beat up in the process. So we want to give him a hard time. He's going to steal his jerseys that he can't even give to his own kid? When his kid gets a little older, starts playing too, he's going to be like, hey, here's my jersey, son. I mean, or his kid actually finds out who his dad is? Not somebody else stole it so they can go make some money?
Can't he just get another one?
And just go play the game again?
Why not?
Yeah, you can't do that. No, I mean,
I'm sure they'll find it. There's probably a tracking device in it or something.
Now, what's going to happen is someone's going to put it on eBay. They're going to try and sell it for money. And that's when they'll find it.
The sad part is somebody will pay thousands and thousands and millions.
The sad part is somebody's stealing his legacy from his own kids just for money. That's the sad part.
It's so sad in general. You know, like, it's...
Remember, you guys, integrity is what's most important. All right, like I said, if you can look at yourself in the mirror, say your name. If you look straight at you, that's good. If you have a hard time saying your name looking in the mirror, then you got some problems, my friend. All right, it's time to work those out, because they're gonna build up, and when they build up, they're gonna hit hard. And remember who we say is gonna see you I am.
You are.
So, well, you know, for beautiful Miss Pauline, hopefully we get to see each other this weekend. I'm pretty sure we will.
What? We better.
Yeah, we better. I'm pretty sure of it. So we will talk about a little bit more about a bunch of stuff next week, and I'm gonna go see that guy again. So I'm gonna tell you a little bit more about what I get to see.
Yeah.
I don't want to scare people away, though.
Hey, well, they get scared. And
get scared? That's a tough one for you guys.
Scared of what, you know?
Absolutely. And, hey, if I see what I see, why are you going to knock me what I see? But you probably wish you could see it, too.
Yeah. I do.
Yes, you do. I'm going to show it all to you.
I'm with it.
Uh-huh. With it a lot. Yeah, okay. All right. So, I guess
that's almost about it.
We almost have to go. So, once again, KCAA. Radio.com. You can Ustream us at ustream.tv/channel/KCAA TV. You better reach us at KCAA
1050 AM, 106.5 FM, and 102.3 FM.
Yep, and I want to tell once again Nadine and everybody else that did the collections with me. Thanks so much for showing me that love back when I needed it.
Yep. Right. Shout out to my sister for giving us a topic to talk about.
Yeah, absolutely. And whose birthday? And Marianne.
Marianne, yeah.
Marianne, happy
birthday once again.
And kids, Donna, Mason, Devin,
Jordan.
Take care, you guys. Remember,
I love you.
Everybody deserves to dream.
Bye.
KCAA Loma Linda, 1050 AM, 106.5 FM.